don't need this. I don't need this.
That's mine.
I don't even know what this is.
Firecracker.
All right, let's go freaking heal Evangelo. Healing him also heals me. Fantastic, everybody's health is topped off. Let's go. Welcome, guys, to another one of my build videos for Back for Blood. This time we are doing the Heavenly Healer build for Doc. All needed information for this build is currently being displayed on the screen, so do with it as you will. Please take note that the December 2021 patch changed a lot of cards, and that this build is current as of that December 2021 patch. The purpose of this build is to make a Doc build that is 100% a healing build. It is perfect for that person who likes to play a support class and not get themselves into direct frontal confrontations with the Ridden. This is the person who is going to lay back from the group just a little bit, and they're going to monitor the health of their team, heal those that need to be healed, and be quick on the draw to go ahead and revive anyone who goes down. We focus in this build to give Doc a very fast revive time. She can get her teammates back up and into the fight quickly. For weapons, you can go with basically anything you want with your primary and your secondary weapons. However, what I found worked best was to use a sniper rifle for your primary. That way Doc can shoot those Ridden that are out of range for the rest of her team. She can shoot the ones with high accuracy who are very close to birds without startling the birds. And if you go this route, one thing you should try to do with that sniper rifle is to get attachments that have bullet stumble. It makes a huge difference when you're shooting those Ridden that are farther away and causing bullet stumble, and that way your team is not getting overburdened by mass hordes coming in. For the secondary weapon, I go with the Tech 9. It's a burst pistol, which is great when Doc finds herself in closed corners, inside houses, or when the Ridden suddenly sneak up on her from behind. Remember, this is a support class character. Doc will be hanging back, so she's going to be watching the tail end of the group to make sure no one creeps up on her main group. But she's going to be watching their health, and she's going to jump into action whenever she needs to. So let's take a look at the cards. We're going to start off with Support Scavenger, a utility card. You can sense nearby support accessories, and more support accessories spawn. This is a great card to have in Doc's arsenal, and especially a good card to have as the very first card. Doc is going to be able to see where those bandages and those pills and those first aid kits are, and that's what she's all about. Second, we have Breakout, another utility card. When Doc holds the E key, she's able to break herself out of grabs. She has a plus 50% breakout cooldown reduction, and base is 60 seconds. So every 30 seconds, she's going to be able to go ahead and use this ability. And this is an important ability. If a Ridden gets by the main group or sneaks up on Doc from behind and they grab her and they incapacitate her, if the group is busy, they may not be able to get to her. Doc needs to be able to break out of these holds all on her own. Worst case scenario is the other three members in your party are down and they're relying on Doc to get them back up. And if Doc gets grabbed, she needs the ability to break free. If she can't break free, all is lost. So this is a great card for Doc to have in her collection. We follow this up with Charitable Soul, a defense card. Healing a teammate also applies 50% of the effect to you. And this is a great reason for Doc to heal her teammates, because every time she heals them, she's going to top off whatever damage she has on herself. She's going to keep herself healed. So if you got the ability to do so, heal your teammates and heal often. Next, we are going to focus on allowing Doc to get her fallen comrades up very quickly and back into the fight. So we're going to start off with Rousing Speech, a utility card. Plus 225% revive speed. It disables offensive accessories. So yeah, that's the drawback. She won't be able to carry grenades or pipe bombs or anything like that. But again, she is a support class character. She is not about the combat. She is there to do one job, and that's to keep her team up and fighting. This card also has a team effect of plus 20 reduced in-cap trauma. And trauma is the hardest damage in the group to get rid of. So by reducing the chance of your party being able to get trauma is going to help the entire group immensely. We follow this up with Smelling Salts, another utility card, plus 200% revive speed. So Doc now at this point has 425% revive speed. When she goes to get somebody up who is down, she's going to get them up very quickly, very, very quickly. So yeah, don't be afraid if they're surrounded by a bunch of ridden. Just get your ass in there and get them back up. You're going to revive them very quickly. And to complement this card, we're going to go with Pep Talk, another utility card. While reviving teammates, take 3 less damage from all ridden. It also heals your teammates for an additional 10 health when you revive them. So yeah, like I said, if your teammate is down and he's surrounded by ridden, don't let them sit there and beat on him. Get your ass in there and get him up. Sure, some of them may hit you, but you're going to take less damage and you're going to get them up very quickly. You'll be in and out in no time. We follow this up with Shoulder Bag, a defense card, plus 2 support inventory, minus 10% damage dealt. Do not worry about that damage dealt. You are not the damage dealer of the group. You have 3 other people in your group who are the damage dealers. That's not to say you're not going to be helping with the fight, but you just don't need to be doing the most damage. But that plus 2 support inventory is going to allow you to carry more health packs, more bandages, more pills, whatever you find. It's going to allow you to carry more of those items that allow you to heal your teammates. And in similar fashion, we're going to go with Belt Clip, another utility card, plus 1 quick slot inventory. This allows you to carry 1 extra defibrillator. So yeah, this is great, because if you have a teammate who dies and then a few minutes you have another one who dies, having more than 1 defibrillator on you and being able to revive your teammates is great. It's going to keep you alive. They are your meat shields. You want to keep them up. You want to keep them alive. You want to keep them healed. Next, we go with Medical Professional, a defense card. First aids and defibrillators also recover 15 trauma damage and 1 extra life. So yeah, you have a teammate who just died, they got killed, and you use a defibrillator and you bring them back, you're giving them 1 extra life back. So that's awesome. And the fact that you're healing 15 trauma damage is outstanding, because again, as I mentioned earlier, trauma damage is the hardest damage to get rid of. Usually the only way you can get rid of trauma damage is by one of the health stations on one of the walls of one of the buildings. So great card for Doc to have in her arsenal. As we approach the end cards of the deck, we jump into Field Surgeon, a defensive card, plus 60% healing efficiency, minus 50% use speed. That plus 60% healing efficiency is outstanding. It's going to allow you to heal more. It's going to allow you to heal faster. It's just going to be overall a good experience for the person who's on the other end. You're the person getting their health back up. That minus 50% use speed, ouch, that's a big hit. But the next card is Combat Medic, another defensive card. Plus 50% use speed. So there you go. We just gained that 50% right back. It also heals teammates for an additional 20 health when you revive them. So yeah, this is great. You revive a fallen teammate, boom, they come back with 20 additional health. So win-win. Next, we go with Experienced EMT, a defensive card. When you use a medical accessory, the target gains plus 10% maximum health, stamina, and stamina regen until the end of that level. That's huge. I expect that in the future we might see this card actually get nerfed, because that's just a really powerful card right there. Plus 10% maximum health, plus 10% stamina, and plus 10% stamina regen until the end of that level. And yeah, if you heal Jim Bob over here, boom, he gets all this. Then you heal Sally Sue over there, boom, she gets all this, and they retain that until the end of the level. So a very powerful card. We jump to our 13th card, which is Inspiring Sacrifice, a defense card. It's a team effect. When you or a teammate becomes incapacitated, all teammates heal for 20 health over 15 seconds. This is great. People get grabbed all the time by the tall boys. So even if you're not the one being grabbed, which if you are, you have breakout, you can just break out of it, no problem. But even if you're not the guy or girl who gets grabbed and someone else does, everyone else is still going to get a heal for 20 health over the next 15 seconds. So a really good card to have in the deck. We follow this up with Poultice, a defensive card. When you use a medical accessory, the target heals for an additional 20 health over 30 seconds. So just like that Inspiring Sacrifice, we are giving a plus 20 health overtime when we are using a medical accessory. And we end the build with Group Therapy. When you use a medical accessory, all teammates heal for 8 health. It's not the 20 health we were getting from the last two cards, but it's something. And that's why it's at the bottom of the deck. But still, it's a great healing card for this particular build and complements this deck very well. So that's it, guys. That's my Heavenly Healer build for Doc. I had a lot of fun playing around with this build, and my teammates absolutely adore me when I play Doc. So yeah, it's just a really great build. Like I said, it's focus is to be for that guy who wants to be the support character. Maybe in other games they play, they're not the best fighters, but they love being a support class. They love keeping their team alive. And if that's you, then this is the perfect deck for you. And yeah, it works in Veteran and Nightmare also, so give it a try. And if you do anything with the build, if you tweak it at all or anything, let me know in the comments down below, because I'm always interested to see what you guys actually do to the build to improve it or to make it better for your particular playstyle. I'm always interested in reading those kind of comments, so let me know what you do. And if you like the build, show me some love. Give the like button a little tickle, okay? Subscribe to the channel. Give me some love, you know? Anyway, guys, until next time, keep killing the Ridden. Catch you later.